Praise the Lord. We begin today's worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary. Full of grace, the Lord is with you.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, the
world without end. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to read for you from Psalm 72. Says, for he will deliver the needy who cry out, the afflicted who have no one to help. He will take pity on the weak and the needy and save the needy from death. He will rescue them from oppression and violence, for precious is their blood in his sight. May his name endure forever. May it continue as long as the sun. All nations will be blessed through him, and they will call him blessed. Praise be to the Lord God, the God of Israel, who alone does marvelous deeds. Praise be to his glorious name forever. May the whole earth be filled with his glory. Amen and amen. Brothers and sisters, as we look at the Lord Jesus this evening, he starts, the psalmist starts this part of the psalm by saying, he will deliver the needy who cry out, the afflicted who have no one to help. He will take pity on the weak and the needy and save the needy from death. He uses this word needy many times. Rather, he uses it time after time. And the reason is, brothers and sisters, the Lord looks at us to see if we're able to surrender our lives to him. If we are needy enough to need God fully. That is what the Lord is looking for this evening. The Lord, see, we have a negative connotation about the word needy. Because needy means someone who is desperate. Needy means someone who is not able to help themselves. Someone who hasn't worked hard. Someone who is lazy. Someone who hasn't used the opportunity to make their circumstances better. That's our definition of needy most of the time. But that's not God's definition of needy. God's definition of needy was someone who surrendered his life or her life completely to God and said, Lord, I need you. That is God's definition. God's definition of needy is very simple. Someone, whether they have things or don't have things, whether they are well endowed or not with good things or otherwise, someone who comes into the presence of the Lord and says, Lord, I need you first in my life and I need nothing else. Nothing will satisfy me except you. That is needy. That's what the Lord is looking for tonight. That's what the Lord is looking for from us tonight. And so as we look at the Lord Jesus, as we turn to the Lord Jesus, we look at what the psalmist says. The psalmist also so beautifully says, he uses this word. He says, he will rescue them from oppression and violence, for precious is their blood in his sight. For precious is their blood in his sight. Your blood and my blood is precious in the sight of God. The Lord doesn't take it lightly, brothers and sisters. The Lord doesn't take you lightly. So this evening, as we surrender our lives to God, let's give it all to Jesus. Again and again, God is calling us to surrender completely to him. Let's stand up as we call on the Holy Spirit tonight. Thank you. 1:9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. The Lord wants to cleanse us tonight. But there's something that the Lord loves. See, the Lord loved David for one reason. David chose the place that God chose. And so when David looked at Goliath, he chose the land of Judah because God wanted that. And Judah, the word Judah means praise, which means that as we praise the Lord, there is victory. There is, we don't just raise our voices for the heck of raising our voices. We don't lift up the name of Jesus because we're habited to it. No, we lift up the name of Jesus because as we do that, there is power. And the power of the name of Jesus breaks sin immediately. It breaks sin on this holy ground. Any Goliath in your life and in my life gets broken right now. Right now. And so I want to encourage us as we continue to praise and worship and lift up the name of Jesus. Let's think about any Goliath in our life. It could be irritation, anger, lust, pride, money, a lack of prayer, whatever it is that raises up its ugly head against the Lord in our lives and the work of the Lord in our lives, let's give it to Jesus right now. Because we're going to praise God, we're going to lift up the name of Jesus so that today on this battleground, God will be glorified. So that today the sin may be defeated in our lives. So that today as we go back from this holy place, we may have come with whatever it is, we may have come with sin, we may have come with different things, but we go back with Jesus alone. So just for a few moments, confess our sins to God. And whatever those areas are that are most troublesome, let's just surrender that to God.
blessings that I cannot see. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an outstretched arm,
I'll bless your name.
I'll bless your name.
Let's just continue to bring our lives before the Lord this evening. Let's just give it to the Lord. We're going to continue to praise God so that evil is defeated in our lives and the fullness of God comes in. That's what the Lord wants for us this evening, for His fullness to come in. His fullness. Let's continue to lift up the name of Jesus. As we lift up the name of Jesus, we surrender our lives to the Lord. Give it all to Jesus. Give it all to Jesus. And know that as we raise our hands and as we lift up His name and as we lift up our voices to the Lord Jesus, the Lord comes and the Lord removes everything that is not of Him in our lives.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
Oh,
Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed.
Blessed. Blessed. Blessed is the one to come. Blessed. Blessed. Blessed is the one.
Oh, my dear.
Jesus right now. The Lord is connecting with so many of us this evening. The Lord is connecting with your heart right now. You know it. You know the Lord is here. Don't let anything distract you. Just receive the Lord. We're going to continue to worship until the Lord moves you and me. We're going to continue to worship. The Lord is here. Here, the Lord is saying more than 53 of us were suffering from prayerlessness. As you're touching the Lord, your prayerlessness has gone. The Lord has removed it. The Lord is saying prayerlessness is a greater sin than many things that we consider to be great sins. The Lord is speaking to 5 people here. The Lord is healing you of your eyesight, of your defective eyesight. There are 16 people here with various forms of headaches. The Lord is healing you. 2 people here with lumps. The lump has already disappeared. You can check if it's in a place that you can't check now. Go home and check it. The lump has disappeared, and then come and give God the glory. There are 3 people here with swelling in the feet. The Lord has healed you. You can check your feet. The swelling is gone. 2 people here, the Lord is saying, with unforgiveness, as you forgive, the Lord is saying your knee pain will go. The Lord is strengthening your knee. For 1 person, the Lord is almost reconstructing your knee. The Lord is speaking to 5 people here. The Lord is saying that whatever you do at work, it's not successful, it doesn't work. From today onwards, the Lord is saying it's going to work. There are 11 people here, you're praying about studies and further studies. You're not able to crack it, you're not able to be successful at it. The Lord is giving you success today. The Lord is saying, do not be afraid. The Lord is speaking to 11 people here. The Lord is saying, you fought with a family member today and your heart is not at peace, you're feeling bad for yourself, the Lord is asking you to surrender that family member and surrender your heart. The Lord is healing you right now. The Lord is speaking to 17 spouses here. The Lord is saying, do not be afraid. I am with you. Do not be afraid. I am with you. There's one person here, you want to commit suicide in the past 2 weeks. The Lord is removing that inclination. And the Lord is saying, come to me. Give me your life. Give me your life. The Lord is speaking to two people here. You're worried about some issue with the land that you have. The Lord is removing that problem. The Lord is assuring you of His grace over that land. And the Lord is removing that problem. Encourage the worship team as we continue. Brothers and sisters, let's continue to worship. As we continue to worship, I want to encourage the worship team to speak as the Lord gives utterance.
I saw the globe and I saw a chain which was wound all over the globe, but the loops of the chain were individuals holding hand and interceding for the world.
The Lord is calling us to pray for each other, to intercede for the needs of the world.
Showing a man shooting an arrow.
I sense the Lord speaking to one person here. The Lord is saying, read the word and then speak the word into your life. The Lord is saying, healing will come, deliverance will come.
I see what looks like an engagement ring looking like a trap.
I sense the Lord speaking to one person here. The Lord is saying, you want to go towards marriage, but the way you desire it is wrong. The Lord is saying, wait for me. Wait for me, I will tell you.
Lord, showing vision of an empty wardrobe.
The Lord is saying, there's one person here, you constantly feel like you have no clothes, although you have many. The Lord is giving you the grace to be content with what you have, so that you can concentrate on the things of the Lord and not the things of the world or your own needs.
The Lord is showing a timepiece with the alarm set at 6:30.
I sense the Lord speaking to 11 families here. The Lord is saying, after 6:30 every day, prepare for family prayer. And the Lord is saying, go ahead with it. The Lord is saying, do not prioritize other things over family prayer. For I, the Lord, wait for your family to come to me.
The Lord is showing Israelites carrying a huge ladder together.
I sense the Lord saying, do not be afraid. The Lord is saying, when we pray for each other in faith, great miracles will happen.
Lord, showing vision of racing tracks.
I sense the Lord saying, for many of us, life, we treat life like a race. God is saying, wait on me. Wait for me. I will show you how you are to lead your life. Do not be in a hurry, says the Lord.
Lord, showing vision of an empty well followed by a pond, followed by a sea.
I sense the Lord saying, many of us are empty. The Lord saying, He starts filling us little by little, and then His blessing overflows. The Lord saying, wait for it. Wait for it.
The Lord is showing a dry path forming the outline of a black heart.
I sense the Lord speaking to four individuals here. The Lord is saying, your prayer sometimes leads you into your own perspective because it is not directed towards me. The Lord is saying, direct your prayer to me and I will make your path straight and I will make it flourish. You will not be in a desert, says the Lord. You will have a flourishing life.
Spirit fall fresh on. touch me now, Holy Spirit, fall fresh on me. I need you, touch me now.
Holy Spirit, fall fresh on me. I need you, touch me now. Holy Spirit, fall fresh on me. I need you, touch me now. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end.
Amen.
Amen.